Hi, I'm Bowling Otter.
And I'm Lissy Sandwich.
Welcome to the BS.
The Bowling Otter Show.
We're playing Silence of the Sleep.
Silence of the Sleep.
And now it looks
Sleep.
Like we're in like a, what's this, a casino?
And there's a, this is a party.
The hell is this place? What the hell is this place? It's a very good question.
Yeah.
Everyone's
there's
a silhouette.
Tangoing people. There's no tangoing people. Everybody's just mingling. Hello, sir.
Is that the dude?
Oh.
Is that the bartender?
Yeah.
Who is that guy?
What's in his hand?
A glass. Wine glass, looks like.
Oh, because he's a bartender.
Looks like it. Unless it's like a bell.
Hello, lady.
Might be a bell. Yeah, maybe it's a bell.
Oh, I thought it was a wine glass.
Hello.
Hello.
Good evening. Hello. Good evening. Sorry. Can I get past that room? Absolutely not.
Oh.
I can't let anyone in.
Why?
Why? What's inside? Well, it is, I guess I could tell you. There's something valuable in that room.
Oh, great.
But I forgot something inside. Good try. Sorry. Actually, it wasn't a good try at all.
Not at all. That's a pretty big dude. Oh.
Oh, there's a question marky marker.
Hello, sir.
Hey.
Hey.
Was it 7? No. Oh, sorry, pal. I was so deep in my thoughts. Oh, you lost something? Sort of, yeah. I can't remember the code for the safe.
Uh-oh.
Ah, that happens. Yeah, but it's been 4 days already. I really, really need to get it open. You've spent 4 days with it? Yes, there's something really valuable for me inside.
Uh-oh.
Can I help somehow? Yes, yes. I hid the code somewhere in here, but I just can't remember where.
Oh.
Okay, I'll start looking. Damn, how did I forget that code?
All
right. How did you forget that code? I don't know it.
What's in there?
Okay, it's a painting. I don't think I need it.
All right.
It's still a painting. I still don't think I need it. Junk, junk, junk. Nothing of use.
Okay.
Just more junk. Just junk.
Hiya, Louie.
Just junk.
Louie just walked in.
Just junk.
Well, that's nice. Is there a shadow or something?
I was gonna
like
say that has to have something to do with it.
Okay. What about like the patterns in the shelves over there? Do any of them make numbers?
Oh, it's a painting. I don't think I need it. 696. Oh, weird. I put my flashlight on it.
Oh, okay.
Well, you're an idiot, sir.
I know.
How could you have like gone through that trouble to make that design,
you're an idiot, sir.
And then forget that you ever did it?
I know. Look at
that. How would you ever forget doing that? You're like, I'm brilliant. I spent weeks painting this wonderful thing, painting another painting on top of it. Now I completely forget what I did and where I put that number.
Hi, Lou. You want to come up?
You got it open? Yeah, finally I can see a picture of my family. That's all I have. Oh, man. Here, take this.
Oh, gee.
Maybe you could charm someone special like I once did. You got a red rose.
Uh-oh,
oh, can you give it to the girl?
Lady?
No problem. Thank you.
Hi, Louie.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. The code is 696. Yeah, I have to write it up. Thanks, pal. You did write it up. It's here on this painting right here. See it? Look.
Yeah, look at that.
Don't worry about writing it. You don't have to write it down.
That,
it's already written down. It's right there. It's right there. You seem like an impressionable lady. Can I give you a rose and you'll just let me pass?
Louie.
I'm not going to give you this rose. She could misunderstand. Okay.
Okay.
I'm glad they didn't just have us do that.
Yeah,
that would have been a little silly.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, wait. The bartender?
Do you want a rose, sir?
Wait. There was a lady out there with red hair, right? Rose red hair?
Oh, potentially? Yeah, I think so. Let's see. Dun, 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 dun,
dun, dun, dun, dun. Okay. This one.
Yeah.
Hey. Can hello!
Whoa!
What is this place?
Great hair.
Ah, new face. You are in Moonlight Motel. Huh? Doesn't look like a motel to me anymore. Who are you? And all these people?
Freaking me out.
My name is Alice, and these people. Well, it wouldn't make sense for me to list names, right? Good point. Still trying to figure out where the hell I am. You are not alone there. It's like an endless loop. Loop. What do you mean? We have been stuck in here for an eternity already, or so it feels.
Oh man.
But this place is not too shabby when you make the decision to stay.
Huh?
Don't you want to leave? Well, some of us tried to leave once, but the only way out is through the riddle.
Uh-oh.
So we worked together to try and solve the riddle, but there were too many of us. People turned against each other. We decided to bury it all and try to get along. Things are better now. I'm sorry, I'm not sure I follow. Ah, silly me. Let me explain. When we first arrived, a man with a red tie and pale face appeared.
Yeah?
He said we were his guests and we could stay as long as we wanted. However, he also told us we are all free to leave, but not without consequences.
Consequences?
consequences. What do you mean? Tried to leave. Ah, the riddle. At first we liked it here, but after some time, Daisy began to feel the same. Same conversations with the same people, nothing ever changed.
Okay.
That's when our frustration started to show. At the time, it felt like our last effort together. We decided to solve the riddle. This place was slowly driving us mad.
Okay.
But it was too late for that. The scar was already there, and we were too stubborn to forget. It felt like a miracle that we were all still on good terms. It still does. Besides, I'm not sure any of us really wanted to leave for the unknown. Why? We don't know what is beyond. It feels safe in here. And that riddle, I think it wouldn't have been too hard to solve. To my understanding, the meaning of it is more symbolic than anything.
Hmm.
Quite a story.
Yes.
Say, you don't happen to have anything related to that riddle. Actually, I do have something. Not sure why you need it, but here, take it.
You got
something strange. Thank you. My name is Jacob, by the way.
We know our name.
It was nice chatting. I have to be going now. Goodbye, Jacob. Okay. Have fun on your ladder.
Yay.
What's going on here?
Have fun on your ladder. What are you doing? I just need to say that Louis is staring at me right now. Like, hold on, I'll make a mark where my camera is so I can put it back. But look. That's what he's been doing.
Hello.
The entire time you've been reading.
He's like looking up at you like,
now he's gonna walk away.
I'm gonna wait till you
now
least expect
it. Now he's gonna walk
away.
Look at this. Now he leaves. Now he leaves. Whatever, dude. Whatever, dude. Okay.
Okay. All right, well, that's out
that
of order.
The whole time, he was like, staring.
So we didn't get, like, we don't have any use for the rose yet, right? That's, we haven't seen anything.
Ooh. No. What's
in here?
This looks pretty complicated.
It looks like a rail for something.
Okay. What is this?
Looks like a rail for
something.
Are
our batteries going to die? I don't think so.
Doesn't seem so.
What was this something strange we got?
Can we even examine anything? A piece of paper with patterns on it. Instructions, maybe? Aha.
Okay,
corner,
so
corner,
this
middle.
Corner, middle. Yeah.
Okay.
All on the left side of the room. Wait, does it have anything to do with those three boxes in there? Look.
Yeah.
Can you do anything with them?
Just says it looks like a rail for something.
So we can't interact or anything.
No. We saw that rose.
Yeah.
It's a dead end. It's a dead. Oh, no.
Oh.
Oh, you know what? Before we do this, I'm going to save again.
Okay, good.
Several things have happened.
Yes, this is true. Louis, stop it! Now you can see. Look over there. Look what he's doing. Look.
Yeah, he's just staring.
He's just staring.
What are you guys doing?
I know, that's exactly what's happening. We do this every night, Louis. Freaking me
water.
Out!
Ooh.
Oh, this is nice. Oh.
Okay. It's a cool rain effect. I like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, that's nice.
Psst, hey you, come over here. Oh,
he's selling drugs.
You got stuff? I got the money, you got the money. I got the money, you got stuff.
You got the stuff.
Sorry I called you like that.
That's okay, what do you have in mind?
Say, have you noticed that red-haired lady hanging around in the lounge?
Yeah, I noticed her. Why?
Well, it's a bit awkward.
Well, call me again if you can spill it out. I love her!
I love her! Oh my
goodness. I've been wanting to talk to her, but I don't know how. You look like a man that knows his way around women.
What? Based on what?
Well, I don't consider myself a ladies' man, but what did you have in mind?
I've gotten some...
Excellent, I want you to get me a date with her.
I've gotten some poo naughty
in my day. Now, before you refuse
to
listen up, I have something you'll need it if you are ever going to leave this motel.
Huh? Why don't you use it and leave?
Well, this piece alone is not enough. Besides, there is this lovely lady.
Fair enough. You mentioned I will need more than just one piece to get out. What was that all about?
Well, this motel is some kind of riddle. You need to collect all the pieces and solve the riddle. I'm not sure, though. The man with the red tie told us this. He said we needed all the pieces if we ever wanted to leave this place. He added that we could stay as his guest, but also mentioned the twisted darkness that would befall us if we were to leave.
Oh, this reminds me of Always Sometimes Monsters.
Oh, yeah.
This is so awesome. I miss your voice.
There is no other way out.
I'm afraid now this is the only way. We once tried to solve the riddle with the residents of this motel that did not end well.
I know.
I don't get it. That man obviously does not want us to leave. Why give us a chance?
Yes, I've been thinking about that. I think it is our damnation. While there is hope, we push through, fighting the pain, only to deceive ourselves. But without hope, what is left? Only pain and despair.
But let's cut to the chase. What do you want me to do?
I have written a letter to her, but there is something I want to include.
I'm listening. A red rose!
Oh, what do you know?
Where could I find one? Maybe in my pocket?
Yeah?
That's the thing, I swear I saw a rose somewhere. I just need to look around. Okay, we'll get back to you once I have found it and looked in my pocket. Thank you so much! Oh, please don't tell the red-haired woman any of this. Okay. Hey, look.
Well,
I was looking in my pocket, and I found a red rose. Here you go. Did you find it? Yes, I found it in my pocket. Ooh, exciting. Now I'll just slip rose petals in and seal it. Glad it's sorted out. May I have my reward now? I was kind of hoping you could give this letter to her and tell her, you know, that she has an admirer.
Oh, really? I mean, really? Ah, to hell with it. I'll give the letter to her. I gotta seal the letter. Yes, once you deliver the letter, come back to me for your reward. Trust me, I will.
I don't know about this, gay.
Boom, 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 boom. So what makes you think if she accepts the date, you're gonna be able to stand in front of her and have a conversation with her? Because this isn't really going well so far for you.
Yeah. And he's a little... You made him sound, like, a little creepy.
Well, he was like, hey, come over here.
Yeah, he was.
I was supposed to give you the letter, but I'm sure I could put this to a better use.
What? How?
What better use? What?
What?
What? Do I have to give it to the other girl? That doesn't make any sense at all.
Why? Oh, it would get her away from the door.
Yeah, but aren't we supposed to get a piece of the puzzle back from the other guy? Why would there logically be a better use for the letter than to give it for the girl that he wanted to give it to?
I know.
That doesn't make any sense.
Oh, wait a minute. Are we allowed to reload again if this doesn't go well?
It doesn't look like it.
Oh, no.
It doesn't look like it's a load game option.
Well, we can't...
Look at this! A delivery for you. What's this? A letter? Let's see what it says. Love. Together for eternity.
Oh, boy.
Cheesy.
Sorry, did you say something?
Oh, boy.
No, it's my throat. Cheesy. Hi, say, who is this missing gentleman?
Hi!
Hi! You want to say that to someone in the middle of a conversation?
Yeah!
Just be like, yeah, well, what did you do yesterday? Hi! I wanted to go see a movie!
It's the guy that hangs around the fountain.
Bartholomew Fitzjeffrey?
Yes.
Bartholomew Fitzjeffrey?
Sounds like our guy.
Oh, thank you for delivering this letter. Oops, I skipped that. No worries. Do you think you could guard this door for a little while?
Well, I'm not in any hurry now, so why not?
But promise me you won't enter the room.
I would never.
Thanks, I'll be back soon. Bye! Hi!
We didn't really... Bye, hi!
Okay, well, let's just go in then.
Okay.
Like we're not supposed to.
Oh, I know.
Alright, what's
all right,
this?
What's
this?
That?
You got a piece of a riddle? Oh my god! What was that?
Oh.
I'm losing it.
What was that? Was there anything
else crap.
In here?
There is a letter.
Uh-oh.
My name is Lisa. Oh. I feel insecure. I'm writing this letter. Oh, that is all there is.
Oh. Hi!
Is that the same person? Because there was a letter in the other one that was like a small piece, remember?
I don't know.
There's a letter in another one that we couldn't pick up. It just had a short phrase on there.
Oh, right.
So maybe those all get pieced together.
So are we just going to stand here? Or are we,
Yeah, what's a big and heavy ring-shaped object?
It looks like a boob.
A boob object.
It's a boob!
How's a ring-shaped object, but it has like a floating thing in the middle of it?
It's a boob.
It's not connected to it at all.
I wonder if it has anything to do with that symbol that's on the doors.
Hmm.
Like it's got like the ring in the
middle.
Oh,
that's that dude that we've already dealt with.
Right. All right, where else?
Should I go back and talk to Bartholomew Fitzjeffrey? Oh, wait.
Be like, yay, we go. Look at this guy.
Oh.
Hey, sir.
Look at that. It was a sequin jacket there, sir. Is that what I spy?
It is. He has one leg.
Hello, Mr. Reeves. Hey,
hello. Hey, wait, how did you know my name?
Oh.
Not feeling too well today, Jacob?
I can't say I am. Who the hell are you?
Don't you recognize me?
No, I have no memories of life before all this.
You understand you are traumatized, yes?
Really, who are you?
Jacob, I am your psychologist.
Oh.
I had a shrink?
Why? You must understand, Jacob, here can only be in after the acceptance. But I can't give you that, Jacob. You must take this journey. So much lies buried beneath, more than you could ever imagine.
What is this? Am I insane?
No.
No, Jacob, you are far from insane.
I'm not too sure about that.
I understand what it must feel like, but listen, don't trust these people. They are ghosts. Mere lies.
Ah!
I sense you are not here to stay. Am I right, Jacob?
You got that right. I need to make some sense of all this.
Okay.
That is a good thing, Jacob. It is the only way to heal your scars. I have kept this for you, Jacob. You will need this once you are ready to leave.
Ooh. Thanks, I suppose. I got another piece of
another
a riddle.
Boob.
I wish I could help you more on your journey. Who knows? Perhaps at some point I can again offer my assistance on my sequin jacket.
Ah! I want a psychiatrist with a sequin jacket and a guitar. Me like, tell me about your problem.
When rain keeps falling and wind blowing, with her cold hand rocks the cradle of a child. Preparing a new journey to the coming road of unknown.
Try.
I don't know. It's unknown.
Oh.
The coming road of unknown.
Look at him.
Yeah.
He's a cool guy.
That sequin jacket, I'm jealous.
I know.
I want it. I want that jacket.
Can we just be like, hey, can we borrow your jacket for a little while?
Yeah, can we have that jacket?
Can we just borrow it?
It would really help
a lot,
if we could just have that jacket.
It would. I'd feel so much better about myself.
So that makes you think, like, a psychologist, that means we're in, like, sleep therapy or something like that? Or hypnotized?
I don't know. Maybe we're hypnotized.
And maybe he's, like, showing up every now and then and be like, hey, man, hey. You know, stick to the plan here.
That's a really good
thing. Hey, fellas, can't you play anything else? I beg you.
Oh, jeez.
What was?
Well, they've been there forever.
Oh, yeah, you're right. This is, like, perpetual.
Yeah.
Never changes. Let me save it again.
Okay.
Tucker's right-hand lady. I still don't know why. I was like, I could surely get a... I don't get the... That's strange. Hey, Alice. Hi, Jacob.
Hi.
I'm sorry to ask, but how did you end up in here? You tell me. I have only fragments of the past, if they're even real memories. It's hard to explain. There's no clear image of things, only strong feelings. I can see pitch black night and something sparkling in the air. Then everything turns twisted in the blink of an eye and my heart skips a beat.
Oh my.
Then comes the warmth. It feels as if I'm nothing more than a spirit. I try to reach higher, but instead I wake up in this hotel.
This is very, like,
I'm
transcendental,
sorry.
Man.
Don't worry, Jacob. Maybe it's for the best that we don't dig deeper. Might be. I need to go. Take care of yourself. You too, Jacob.
You too, Jacob. So we go back to
so it's out of order, we still go in.
Fitzroy McFace, and tell him that we give it to the right one. Oh.
Nothing happened. Nothing happened. Nothing happened. Nothing happened. Nothing happened.
Okay. Nothing is happening. Okay.
Yeah, nothing
happened.
So nothing
we have
happened.
To do like right, left, right, left, right, left, right. Right, right, left.
Yeah,
right,
there's going to have to be like some that. Sequence to
now,
it.
Now, can we examine those riddles?
No, they just say a big heavy ring. I have two big heavy ring-shaped objects. So I think I need to put them somewhere.
What about that room with the squares? It said some rail, some kind of rail.
Yeah, maybe we can use them all there. You're right. Is that in here? Yes, it
yeah.
is.
Can we put one of the riddles in there?
Yes.
Ah!
Yes, well, I inserted a piece.
Okay. All right, so we need one more.
And the guy's got it. Jeffrey Fitzroy, Fitzsimmons, Fitzhappy.
He does.
Jeffrey.
Oh, well, oh no. Maybe we should have gone to him first. Oh no, because she talked to him.
Yeah, she talked to him. Yeah.
She would hit him before we hit him, even if we... Be like, dude, we're a douchebag.
I have delivered the letter. Great, how did she take it? No, wait, don't say. As promised, here, take this. Thanks. I'll get going now. Wow, we're a douchebag.
We are.
That was not very nice.
Louis's back.
Oh, boy.
Louis's back and he's staring. Louis, what are you doing?
Okay, we're going to put the final piece in here.
So funny.
We're leaving via the riddle. So I guess this is solving the riddle.
Oh, my God. He's, like, burning into my skull.
I inserted a piece.
Can you turn him? Should we go back to the squeaky room? Oh.
Oh,
Do they have to go in a certain order? There was nothing we could do to, like, examine them or anything?
Oh.
What?
That would be this thing here. Duh. Oh, where'd it go? This thing. So upper left corner, lower left corner, and middle. I don't know how to choose where it goes, though.
Oh.
Looks like a rail for something.
Oh, you're gonna have to spin the thing.
Spin the thing.
Go in the other room and spin the wheels, and
it's
gonna move them around.
I gotcha. Okay, this is gonna be interesting.
So you're gonna have to, like, put one on, and then...
Looks like, why can't I put them back on? Oh, because I've not selected them in my hands. Okay. Yes, insert the piece. We'll probably have to spin that to where we want to go. But we're gonna have to put them all in, like, in order that, like... This might be a pain in the butt. Because, like, if we do this... Let me see here. Let's see. So we'd have to put, like...
Wait, and why would one go
halfway? Assuming that one turn only goes halfway.
that we need to put that first piece, get it to the upper right corner.
Okay. Well, wait. Let's. There's a ring there right now, right?
Yeah, you know what?
Let's turn it twice and then go look.
Yeah, we need to get it to the upper right corner.
Okay.
So let's turn. Yeah, turn to the right. Yeah, we'll turn twice. I think something moved.
Okay.
So let's go see where I put it.
Let's see what happened.
It does kind of suck that we're going to have to walk back and forth like this
like
to do this.
Nobody got this in this whole room?
Yeah.
Nobody figured
it out. They all put their heads together.
I know. He said everybody.
Okay, twice was corner, then halfway. So we need to turn it right 1, 2, 3 more times.
Yeah. Okay, then maybe it'll lock in place.
No, I don't think it will.
You don't think it'll lock in place?
No, we're going to have to put them all in a situation where they'll, like, turn the way we want it to all at once.
Now Louise walking around in the curtains. What the heck, man? What is he doing?
He's fine.
He's walking on the windowsills, like, halfway off the window. Now he's up by the curtain rod.
He's good.
Now he's up at the... He's touching the curtain rod. Matthew.
He's fine. All right, hold on. Let me figure this out. All right, so 1, 2, 3. So then we put on...
See that? It's making me nervous.
Oh, I see what we would have had to have done.
What's he doing? Oh, Louis.
So the furthest one is that one. Okay, so I have to put the first one, keep it where it is.
You have
then
to
I'll
go
put
to the third one.
This one in.
Yeah.
So that I'll turn this one once, so it'd be like that.
Yeah.
Then I'll turn this one once, so it'll be like that. And then I'll put this in and turn that one once, and then they should all be in their respective spots. Right?
That makes sense.
Okay. Turn right. That must be it! I mean, that must be it.
That must be it. Now, what did that do?
I have no idea.
You want to just go back in there? We'll take a look.
Yeah. Nobody else noticed.
Yeah, right?
Psst, we can leave! We can get out of here. Ooh.
Oh, the bartender guy. Hello, sir.
You.
Yes, it's me, sir. What the hell is going on? Who are you? Calm down, sir. I am your friend. Listen, sir, you cannot trust anyone. They are only here to confuse you. Enough games. What is this place? Where are these people?
This place cannot be explained in words.
Of course it can't.
And these people? They are malicious, sir. Scum, if you don't mind me saying.
With a capital S.
I'm not buying that. I know you trapped these people here.
I have not trapped anyone. Besides, they are all free to leave.
You knew right from the start they could never leave.
That was never in my hands but theirs. They had a choice they chose not to use.
Oh.
So what now? I solved your stupid riddle.
My riddle? You don't understand, sir.
How could I?
I'm sorry, sir. I understand it's all so confusing. I can't explain the meaning of all of this, but I can show you the path you must travel.
Wonderful.
I must warn you, sir, that road is filled with suffering and terror.
Are you ready, sir?
Yes, I'm ready.
Take me.
Look at the hands.
Chris Angel.
Chris Angel.
He's gonna levitate. He's gonna levitate. Levitate.
He should be, like, laughing maniacally this whole time, like...
Ooh. Now it's like Silent Hill again.
Now we're in the other world.
We're in the other world.
Is that all blood coming out of...
Peek and listen. There are doors throughout the world you can peek or listen through. When you are facing a door like this, one of the following icons appear.
Uh-oh.
When an eye icon appears, you can peek through the door by clicking the right mouse button. When an ear icon appears, you can listen through the door by clicking the right mouse button.
Oh, that's creepy.
Okay, so now we have to use a mouse. Okay. Oh.
Oh, no. Oh, no, that's going to be so creepy.
What the hell do we do?
What if it looks like people? Do we wait till it leaves and then we walk by? We may have to wait.
It's like really close the whole time.
How long do we have before?
We go like right now.
Okay. Oh my god.
Okay, I'm gonna use the gramophone. Yes, I would like to save.
Awesome.
Okay, well, that's gonna be the end of that episode.
Whoa.
Things getting interesting.
Glass broke there?
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
That's
to go to
really
the menu.
Cool.
Alright, well, if you like that video, please click like, favorite, and subscribe. We'll see you tomorrow. Thanks, bye!
Bye!
Okay.
Alright.
Okay, now we gotta go dinner to the fridge. Make sure mom's eats this stuff.
Nasty fridge.
Nasty. Nasty fridge.